Hello guys, welcome to SMA channel. In this class, we are going to see what is meant by if-else statement and how can we use it in Python. So first of all, to write any if-else statement, I think you would have heard about it and you are here. So for writing an if-else statement, you need to know about the syntax for that. So let me give you an example and let me clear you how we can write the if-else statement. Mostly if-else statements will be used inside any loop or inside any function. Okay, so let's get started. So let me define a is equal to 25. And I'm giving the value of 25 to the variable a. In the next step, I'm writing the if-else statement. For that, you can write simply like if. So as I have told you before itself, if you get in green color, it's like a keyword. Like if you write for, it's like a for loop, which we saw in the last class. Same way, print will be in green color. Then if you write return, it will also be in green color. So in that way, you can check whether you have written right or not. So if, and then you have to give any condition. If some condition is true, print this. Else, print that. In that way, we are going to do. So after if is a conditional statement. So you have to give any condition for it. So if I'm giving like A is equal to 25. If, as I've mentioned A 25 here, if A is equal to 25, and then as like in functions, you have to write semicolon. And then I'm asking the if statement to print A. If it is equal to 25, then print A. Then the next important thing is else. If A is not is equal to 25, else, in the same way, you have to write colon, and then else means print B. I'm not defining B here, so let me define it now. B is equal to 30. Okay, sorry. B is equal to 30. So A is equal to 25, B is equal to 30. If A is equal to 25, print A. This is a condition which we have given. Else, print B. So if this condition is not true, do this, okay? We are asking the function to do like this. Sorry, not a function. This is a conditional statement. So let's run this. Yeah, if you see here, it says A is equal to, in this place, we have a syntax error. So like normally we give is equal to, but inside a if statement, you have to give double equal to sign to tell that A is equal to. For that, you need to give double equal to, then only it will work. Is it clear? Fine. So let me run this one more time. So yes, you got 25. If A is equal to 25, I'm telling the if statement to print A. Yes, it's 25. You can see here A is 25, I'm assigning it, and then I'm printing it. So this will be skipped. Because this is true. If this is not true, the cursor will come to the else statement. So let me erase 25 and let me give it as 21. Okay. So let's run this. See. It was checking the if statement and whether this condition was true. If A is equal to 25, it will check with A. A is not equal to 25, it's 21. 25 cannot be equal to 25. So this condition is not true means it won't print this statement. So A will not be printed here. As these two statements are false, it will come to the else statement. If this not happens, we are telling the statement to do this. So else, print B. So then B will be printed. What is the value of B? If B is 30 here, so the value of B will be printed. Even you can use break and continue inside if else statement. Let me clear else statement as if you are clear with this. Okay. Same way in Python, indentation is very, very important for writing any function or for loop or while loop or if else statement. So you have to leave some gap over here. Okay. Or if you don't know the indentation, you can just press enter by keeping the cursor next to the semicolon. Okay. Yeah, it will come rightly. So let me write break. So if A is equal to 25 means break. Break means it will not do anything. So if it is not equal to 25 means, so what should be done? That we can give in the else statement. Let's first see what break does. Run. See, break outside the loop. Because we are not defining it clear. As A is not is equal to 25, it's not breaking because the condition is not true here. Let me give A is equal to 21. If this condition is true, it will go to the next line. If it is not is equal to 2, it will go to the else statement, which we didn't give here. That's why it's saying like break outside the loop. See, can we give continue? Continue and break are the two terms inside if statement which we can use. Okay. It's saying like continue the if else statement and run the loop. So it's not properly in the loop. Because we are not giving a full if else statement. Okay. So giving break and continue we'll see in the next class. So in this class, please remember about the if and else statement only. Okay. If A is equal to 21 means you can print A or do any function with A. Print A into A. Okay. Else you have to write over the margin, else and then semicolon, print b into b. You can also do any calculations over here. So break and continue statements we'll see when we are doing while loop. Okay, so let me run this. See, this is true, that's why 21 into 21 has been printed here. So this is the basic of if else statement. If you understand this, you will be able to do furthermore. So thank you for watching the video. Please like and subscribe SME channel. Thank you.